Hey Sean Jantz here, and I'm doing a quick bottom plan for Tuesday, March 19th, and I'm going to do it on /ES, which is the S&P 500, and the other indices that you can find on NADEX. And I'm going to start here on /ES, and every single evening, I always start on the 4-hour chart, as you can see right there, and that is because, as far as a day trader goes, the 4-hour chart is the most important chart to understand. Is what is our bias on this 4-hour chart? Are we overbought? Are we oversold? Or are we at equilibrium, right? And so you can clearly see what we are. It's not, hopefully you've been watching the last few trade plans. We are at over 5-month highs. We are what? We are severely overbought, right? And it's very rare for the market to just continue shooting higher without seeing some good pullbacks, right? Because that's all the 4-hour chart does, and that's all what any chart does. All it does is cycle. Overbought, oversold, overbought, oversold. Overbought, oversold, overbought, oversold, overbought, oversold. Even more oversold, and then now we're even more overbought. So, right, what is the next logical progression on this chart, right? So, at a minimum, you would know at least not to buy up here. That would be insane, in my opinion. I mean, you can do whatever you want to do. I'm not your daddy. But that'd be crazy buying. We're at a 5-month high. Now, can we still buy this massively bullish market? 100%, absolutely. But we need pullbacks, right? We're now in, I mean, we're up even just a little bit here in the late afternoon session. And so it's very obvious what we are. We're severely overbought. There is no structure up here for over 5 months. If this chart does continue to go higher, there will not be any structure up there. So that does kind of suck, right? So all of the structure, we need this chart to pull back. So there could be some opportunities for looking for some line. It'll be way more, this will be better when we get to the smaller time frames. But there could be opportunities tomorrow trying to take this cycle down. This isn't a negative or positive, but Wednesday is the FOMC interest rate announcement, okay? And so typically when that comes out, right, that is the single most important news announcement, right? So tomorrow could be kind of low volume, people sitting on their hands waiting for Wednesday. And the Wednesday FOMC announcement, that they're not supposed to raise rates, and so I don't foresee too much of market movement with Wednesday's FOMC announcement, but a lot of people do kind of sit on their hands waiting for that to come out, so there's not any surprises. So Tuesday may be a light volume day. You know, normally I would like to kind of see this pushing lower, but we just may not see, right? So you can kind of see an example of like when these bear cycles run, they really run pretty nice and smooth. We may not see it tomorrow, so you need to be mindful of that, okay? So now that we know we're severely overbought, we now move to the 15-day, 15-minute plot chart, right? So here's 15 days worth of price action. You can see we've rallied pretty strong off of that 15-day low. And now we're forming literally as I'm speaking right now. This is showing a 15-day high bubble, but it's even over 5-month high bubble, right? And so what I like to do here is I'm just looking for structure. I'm looking for the best places to buy, the best places to sell. I'm looking for support, resistance, supply, and demand zones. And what I always do is I start exactly where price is, and then I start planning and visualizing. What am I going to do or not do at every single zone if this chart continues to cycle higher? And then what am I going to do or not do at every single zone if this chart wants to finally start cycling to the downside? So let's first talk about if we start cycling higher. Okay, we've already kind of touched on it. There is no structure up here for over 5 months if we do continue to cycle higher. The only thing that you can have up there is you can build some context. There is going to be a plus 0.5 for a possible sell trigger. Okay, you just get up there, wait for accumulation, or I guess wait for distribution change control, right? And then you got a plus one. But you need to be mindful. You need to expect lower win ratios. If you're going to be trading with no structure to the left, always expect lower win ratios. I'm just telling you up front, right? If you want to be high win ratios, confident trades, you always want to trade where there is structure. But I'm not trying to tell you what to do or what not to do. I'm just trying to warn you. I've been doing this a long time, and I traded all-time highs a lot, right? Because we've had a lot of all-time highs the last 2 years. And so this is an all-time high, but I have traded highs with no structure to the left. It can be very difficult, right? So just be mindful of that. You can also do some, if you've taken Michael Perigo's course, you can clearly see some trend line analysis there. So if you can start building some trend lines there, you can absolutely do that as well. My point on that is that that's pretty much all you can draw, some extension trend lines to build some context up there. Okay, but as far as there's no structure, so to be mindful of that. Now let's talk about if we cycle lower, because that's where all the structure is. First things first, you can clearly see we got a good potential bear target to the downside sitting at that VA low Monday negative and a half, right? So you wouldn't just sell yet. You'd want to wait for a line in the sand and ride the momentum. And the line in the sand is very obvious what he'd be. It'd be VA high and set, right? So once we can see these bears start busting through set, and then you find your lower highs, okay, and we can ride them trying to go for an 80% roll. I would use tomorrow anywhere from about 5 to 6 points for TP targets if you're doing touch brackets, at the money binaries, or spreads, or traditional futures. As far as first demand, here's our first contact zone. We got negative and a half Monday POC, but I won't lie, I don't totally love being a buyer right here at 5 month highs. And so I will likely go ahead and skip looking for a buy trigger there. And if I were to buy this chart, at a minimum, I would need to pull back into that negative one, and even, negative or 2800 is going to be really close to our negative one and a half, and then we're going to have negative twos down there. Like I said, I have a hard time thinking we're going to see a dump the day before FOMC, but if we see one, there is going to be structure down here for negative one and a halfs and negative twos, because 2800 is going to be the big, kind of the big, big target for these bears for the next few days. So when the bears finally start running, they're going to be targeting 2800. It's very obvious, right? So we need this to pull lower. There's some good context, good structure down there if we can get this to pull lower. Slash and Q is actually very, very, very similar. We run higher. You got a plus 0.5. The one thing I like about plus 0.5 is that's still no structure there, right? But it is a big round number, 7,400. I could see a lot of these bulls right here, a lot of them taking profits at that psychological 7,400. And when bulls take profits, what happens, right? They're selling back the market. And so they're selling back the market, which induces sellers, right? So I'm not totally against looking for possible change control off plus 0.5. But if you bust through plus 0.5, no structure up here. So basically, good luck, right? Same thing as ZS, get through set, hold lower highs. Good potential 80% roll sitting. Notice how that overlaps, right? So you love it when context overlaps. Generally, a negative and a half and VA low would be a good spot for first demand, but you just need to be mindful of how overbought this chart is. Like if you're gonna buy right there, it needs to be literally a 15 minute scalp, right? Like in and out. And I'm typically not a 15 minute scalper. So if I were to buy this chart, I would need to be pulling back into that negative one, even down into there. So just be mindful that if you buy up here, I'm not saying that you can't. Value a low, negative and a half, it's a good context. You just need to understand what's going on in the 4 hour candle sell trigger. Like, don't be buying here and crying if it continues to dump, right? You know the risk going for that 4 hour candle wants to cycle. So just be mindful of what's going on in the bigger pictures. You can still do some worm's eye view scalping. If that's what you like to do, here it is, you can do it. But you always gotta be mindful of the bigger picture. Now we move on to /YM, which gives us some different opportunities, right? /YM's been dragged down by Boeing, right? There's only 30 stocks inside of this chart. So pretty much like one stock like Boeing can drag it down. And so /YM is kind of sitting here. It is relatively overbought, but it is kind of sitting in the middle. The good news is that when I look up, if we do grind higher, I like that 26,100. You got a plus 0.5, 26,100, decent supply. But if I were to say what's my favorite sell zone, it would be right there, right? Get up into that plus one zone. So either one, find my distribution change control. And then same thing, as far as you can try and look for possible breakouts for an 80% rule, I don't know if I'd look for that, but I wouldn't mind looking for, I think that is a decent pullback into that VA low 25,800. You can actually do a trend line here and you can kind of see, right? So if you start roughly about there, you can kind of see how that trend line is going to be really close to there. And then of course, second demand, it's very obvious where the second demand zone is, right there. Friday, negative one, Thursday POC. And if we really see dumps, we'll have structure for negative one and a half and negative two. I have decided to go ahead and add /RTY. on our charts for the next coming weeks. Bid-ask prices have been getting a little better on NADEX, so I'll add it back. First sell zone, seconds. I'm going to go through this quick, right? And I like keeping these 10 minutes or less, so I'm at the 10-minute mark. First sell zone, second sell zone, very obvious. Another good potential opportunity for 80% rule if you can catch it. And I'm not totally against looking for first buy trigger, and then you got a second buy trigger there. Because you can see how there's our 15-day high, there's our 15-day low. We're pretty much in the middle. So I do like how, notice the differences. ES, RTY, we're getting, I like how they've diverged because it's creating different opportunities on all four of these charts. So, and I don't try and trade all four at the same time. That's silly. Pick your favorite chart at that moment that has the best edge, best content, best contacts. Stick to that chart. Don't be trying to trade all of them at once. So, because they're roughly, right? They will diverge because of certain individual stocks, but they're roughly 75 to 80% correlated. So you can't be trading all of them at once. It's basically the same trade, right? And so always pick the chart that has the best edge, best prices on NADEX, lots of factors. So message me if you have any questions. Take pictures of all of your trades and post them in the group and in the chat room so that you can get feedback from me and from others.